Hello and welcome. The 2023.2 software release greatly expands support for communication protocols and features that will help you better model and test EVs and the EV charging process. These include support for the plug and charge option in ISO 15118 for automatic billing and secure smart charging communication, XCP calibration and diagnostics protocol and AR/XML configuration file support for engine control using CAN and bus, LIN protocol support for low bandwidth applications such as lighting, climate control, and door systems, and variable length message support over J1939DM1 for reporting diagnostic trouble codes in heavy-duty vehicles. In this tutorial, we will go through how to use the ISO 15118 plug and charge and XCP over CAN protocol implementations. For full documentation on all features, please check the links in the description below. Let's start with the ISO 15118 plug and charge feature. This feature enables secure smart charging communication using certificates and transport secure layer protocol, without the need for additional authentication steps. It includes functionality for charging and making any associated payments. To demonstrate this feature, we created a model that consists of both an electric vehicle communication controller, or EVCC, and a supply equipment communication controller, or SECC, running in two HIL devices, with a DC charging configuration. In this example, we have the SECC on the left and the EVCC on the right. When opening the component properties, you can see that more options were added in the supported services section. When contract is selected as the payment option, a new option will appear in the dialog box to import the certificates for the SECC. Let us click on Choose Folder and select the folder where our certificates are located. For the plug and charge feature to work properly, you need to make sure you have all the necessary files inside the certificate folder. So, let's navigate to the folder containing the necessary certificates, keys, and passwords from the EVCC we want to connect to. The files shown here should be present in this folder. For more information about these files, please refer to our documentation. After you select this folder, you can also choose a relative or absolute path. Once you click OK, the setup is done, and the necessary files will be available to the SECC component during your communication tests. Now let's open the EVCC component and check the properties for plug and charge. When the connection type is changed from trusted to secured connection, a new option to import the certificates appears in the dialog box. Certificates are now required whenever secured communication is selected, whether you are using plug and charge or an external payment. To select the right certificate, click the Choose Folder option and navigate to the folder containing the necessary certificates. These certificates will be imported into the EVCC component in order to establish the desired communication. In this case, only two files are required, which correspond to the certificates shown in this folder. After selecting the folder, let's make sure the payment option is selected in the EVCC dialog in Contract Payment. Now, we can compile and load the model to a multi-HIL setup to check the plug and charge in action. Here, we have configured the log for both EVCC and SECC to be sent over UDP protocol, so we can check the log messages in real time on the host PC. After starting the simulation, we can change the CP and PP states to trigger ISO 15118 communication. In the SCADA and log messages, we can see that both the EVCC and SECC are communicating. Let's look at these messages in detail. First, we can see that at session setup a secured TLS connection is established between the SECC and the EVCC. After that, in the payment service selection, a contract is chosen, and the certificate handling process is triggered. The communication then proceeds to the charger parameter discovery and charging loop states. With this implementation, we can now model a complete plug and charge session using ISO 15118. Now, let's look at XCP over CAN protocol. This feature is implemented in the HIL SCADA panel, so any model can be used to test it. For this demonstration, we use the RLC circuit model from the example library. XCP Master is supported in the Typhoon HIL toolchain in HIL SCADA, via the Python library PyXCP, while the parsing and importing of the A2L file is supported via the Python library PyA2L. XCP Slave is currently not supported in the Typhoon HIL toolchain. To present this feature, we added a macro widget on the SCADA panel and included the following Python code in the on-click tab. To make PicCP easily accessible in the SCADA, an XCP wrapper Python script is provided from Typhoon HIL. For more information, please refer to our online documentation. Now let's see how to use this script inside HIL SCADA. First, we should add the paths for the folder we are working on, the DLL that contains the XCP key for the ECU, and the JSON file that describes the transport type, master and slave ID, and bitrate. To access additional Python scripts in your simulation, you will need to append the path for the script to the system path, like this. After that, you can use the PyXCP connect, disconnect, upload, and download functions to interact with the slave device. For unlocking a slave resource, its DLL file must either be in the same folder as the SCADA file or its path must be appended to the system path. To parse an A2L file to retrieve the necessary information, the A2L file must be imported into an open database. Then, after a session is opened, it must be closed when the needed operations are done to use the database again. This part of the code is an example of how to use the functions defined in PyXCP and implement the XCP wrapper script. The function getSeed and unlock gets the XCP seed key and unlocks the specified resource. The following part of the code is to set and get values from slave specific characteristics and measurements. GetMeasurement uploads the specified measurement value from slave to master. SetCharacteristicValue downloads the specified characteristic value from master to slave. GetCharacteristicValue uploads the specified characteristic value from slave to master. Also, the createMeasurementList function creates a DAQ, which stands for Synchronous Data Acquisition Sequence. Once the DAQ sequence is started, the results are stored in the two dictionaries initialized before, the CommonDict and DataDict dictionaries. Now let's test a virtual ECU with Vector Canopy software using this SCADA implementation. First, let's open Vector Canopy and select the XCP demo example from Vector. This example simulates a virtual ECU in the host PC running the XCP slave protocol. Let's start the virtual ECU in Canopy, which opens a console showing the debug of the XCP slave running in this ECU. In the Typhoon HIL SCADA software, click the macro to run the XCP overcon script. If everything went well, you will see the variables measured from the XCP slave in the SCADA message log, as shown here. Thank you for watching.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit HIL.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.